that in a rural area, there were roads which had come up. And you know, I could hardly sleep before I landed up at a place, because earlier it used to take 1 hour and it was taking 10 minutes. So the car, I could not even take a nap in the car, and I used to ask the driver that, have you reached the destination? And that was very surprising for me, and I thought that the change in Bihar had begun, and the right change. Bihar, which was not included as a part of India, started getting included. So I think that that was the first inclusion. For me, that was an inclusion, that Bihar got included in the mainstream India, in the mainstream world economics and politics. So I think that that was where the inclusion of Bihar started off. That was a time when the government was also coming out with a lot of plans of seeing that what could be done in villages. There was an opportunity which we saw in starting off e-governance in the villages, and being a person from the village, this was the first opportunity, and I thought that let's start from the bottom of the pyramid. And that's how we got into this program of the e-governance. And today, we have no complaints, because the things always in infrastructure go slow. Though nothing much has happened on the e-governance side, we are still in trickles that the services have started flowing. It's 4 years, we have invested 60 crore in Bihar on the e-governance side. We are losing money, but still we have not lost our heart, because we feel that this is the state which is the state of tomorrow, because there is a huge potential of the people here. People like us who have gone out of Bihar, out of villages, and have done well. We feel that, you know, today we, fortunately I'm running an organization which is today managing about 50,000 crore of assets in infrastructure. We do financing of infrastructure, of equipments, projects, developing power plants, developing roads, ports, in all these particular areas. And it all started because I think that the foundation was laid down here in Bihar. Because what it gives to a person is the understanding that how to have that killer instinct, the native intelligence, that you have absolutely a dream and you can dare to dream. And that is what all Bihar has. So that's a huge repository. We may feel that these are intangibles, so therefore it carries no meaning. But I think that this is what makes Bihar what Bihar is. So I think that, you know, on the path of inclusion, there's a long way for Bihar to go. I would not say that, you know, Bihar has come to a stage where it is already included. It has started getting included. And I think that the dream for Bihar should be that it should get conspicuously and ubiquitously included, not only as a part of what is happening in the country, but also of the world. It is always, as they say, that, you know, India, we started late, and that is why it became one of the best destinations for investors to come in. We were able to embrace technology, and in many areas, the technology is even more developed and more advanced, which people use in day-to-day lives, even compared to the US or Europe, because we started off late. So similarly, I think that there is an advantage that in Bihar, we started off late. So therefore, whether it is embracing technology, whether it is embracing infrastructure, whether it is development on the agricultural side, I think all these can come in, and we can create a model, we can create a trajectory which we want to, and not what is forced upon us. And their biggest advantage is that we would be in a position to learn from the mistakes which the other states and other places people have made. So those are the learning lessons which, if we take it in a constructive manner and we think through it, I think that we can bring in a lot of growth, and the potential which lies in Bihar can be unleashed. And I think that that is where the basic concentration of the government should be, and I'm very pleased to see that it is truly so. The first thing which the government here did, and all compliments to the Chief Minister and the Deputy Chief Minister and the entire team of politicians and bureaucrats which are there, that they first of all said that, you know, there must be connectivity. So roads were created, whether in the rural areas or anywhere, roads were created. Second was law and order. The people, I arrived yesterday evening, and people said that, you know, you can travel till about 11:30, 12 in the night, and there's no danger. You're not going to get kidnapped, you're not going to get mugged. So therefore, that was very good news, because people want to be in a place where law and order situation is good, where you feel safe and secure. Because if you're not safe and secure, you don't want to. And these were the two critical areas which the Bihar government did concentrate on. And I think that after that, where the inclusion is concerned, agriculture is a huge scope, because Bihar has always been the greenery of India. So therefore, if this can be well exploited and we can take advantage of the situation in Bihar and see that how we include people, because again, Bihar is a late starter. So therefore, there is an advantage that if productivity can be increased, it has huge advantage of the land being very fertile. So you can have a lot of organic growth of agriculture, which can be there. And today, everyone knows that organic food and organic grains have a very high value in the international market. So agriculture could be one particular area where I think that we should get a model created which will be inclusive. The second area where I think is IT, because it has already started in the rural areas. The e-governance program which we have taken, though it has started a little slowly, but I think that a lot of facilities can be brought in the rural areas through these particular centers which has been set up. We have already set up 4,000 centers in the rural areas. When we are talking about in the morning, the minister, deputy chief minister was talking about that how we can bring in a convergence, that there is an infrastructure which has got created, there's a huge amount of there are VLEs, village level entrepreneurs, who are not seeking employment, but they are entrepreneurs who are going to create employment. So therefore, it is an inclusive model that we try to build up. So how can you bring in convergence, that a lot of services which can be disseminated to the villagers, to the people at large, whether it be banking, whether it be insurance, whether it be mutual funds. So how can we bring it to the doorsteps of the people who want to save and who had not got these facilities which was there earlier? So that's one of the models for inclusion which I would say. The other area for inclusion would be on infrastructure. Roads have already happened, so therefore there is a connectivity which is there. The second area is power. I think electricity is something, and we have just seen, witnessed, that for a fraction of a second when electricity goes away, then how disabled we feel. So just imagine that in rural areas when there is no electricity for days together, for years together. So what kind of despondency would be there? So therefore, electricity power is another area where I think that which can be taken up, because it will really include and become inclusive of bringing people together. Because if it connects them, it provides them electricity for agriculture, it will help them to reduce their cost. So I think that that is another area which should be taken up in all earnestness. And I think that there are a lot of models which exist today on public-private partnerships which can be brought up. Some the government has to take up definitely. Some models can be worked on.
Mr. Kanodia, about a couple more.
Sorry. I was keeping that track. I thought it was just one more minute left.
I've given you more than
so I think that the other area is which I would like to mention before I conclude is the people. I think that here there is a great advantage that we have a large population. It's not a bane, it's a boon. We should take advantage of that. We should create centers where we can train up the people in various disciplines of trade, of business, of being self-employed, and we can send them to other states. As it is, there's a lot of Bihari workers who are working in agriculture in so many states, but why only in agriculture? They are working in construction, but how can we take them up on the value chain? So I think that I would just suggest that these are some of the ideas which I had on the inclusion, but you all are from here, so you would know that what would work and what would not work. But being a person from Bihar, I've always been interested in seeing that whatever we can give in and work together to create some more inclusive models, we'll be very happy to do that. Thank you very much.